हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वी आर हेलो फ्रेंड्स, इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न द डिफरेंस बिटवीन नील रेटेड, एग्जेम्प्ट, जीरो रेटेड एंड नॉन जीएसटी सप्लाइज. ऑल दीज फोर आर डिफरेंट. अंडरस्टैंड दिस टेबल. वी हैव अ कॉलम कॉल्ड सप्लाई नेम एंड द डिस्क्रिप्शन. जीरो रेटेड सप्लाई मीन्स एक्सपोर्ट्स supplies made to SEZ or SEZ developers, SEZ units or SEZ developers. So these are the only such three things. If you are making these type of supplies, then that falls under the zero rated supplies. Nil rated supply. Nil rated supply means the 0% GST. The supplies that have 0%, I do not call this as zero rated tax. This is zero rated, that is different. And now the supplies that have nil rated GST is this. The examples are salt, grains, jaggery, etc. One beautiful thing about this nil rated tax is you can claim the ITC, the input tax credit, which is very, very essential for any businessman. Exempt supplies. Supplies that are taxable but do not attract GST. I repeat, supplies that are taxable but do not attract GST and ITC cannot be claimed because such goods are exempted. Why you do not pay the GST on exempted supplies? It is because the GST Act says so, or the notification given by the government says so. Exemptions are given for a time limit, and if that time limit exceeds, then automatically exempted supplies become the taxable supply, or as notified by the government, the GST council or the government can through the notification give the list of exempted goods and services. And now the non-GST. These supplies do not come under the GST law because they are non-GST goods or services. Example, alcohol for human consumption is the only one example because the constitution itself has kept alcohol out of the GST. But the petroleum product is included in the GST, but GST is not applicable on this, right? Because it is a state matter. Further understanding, nil rated means this is the type of supply that attracts a GST of 0%. Input tax credit can be claimed on such supplies. Some items which are nil rated include grains, salt, jaggery, etc. The same is repeated here, which we have learnt in the previous slide. But please understand, this is what you are copying down, and if it is asked in the examination, explain the differences between these all, then you are writing the same points. Exempted supplies. This supply includes items which are used for everyday purposes, because that in the previous video we have seen the items of public interest are exempted generally by the government. Since they are basic essentials, they do not attract GST at all. You will not be able to claim any ITC on such supplies because they are directly the consumer goods. Because they are consumer goods, they are directly consumed by the consumers itself, and that too for the basic essentials. Some examples are like bread, fresh fruits, milk, curd, etc. These are the basic essentials. This also include rice, wheat and edible oil, etc. Zero rated supplies made overseas. Overseas means exports out of the country and to SEZ, special economic zones. This is the special economic zone. This is the special provision given in the GST Act for the SEZs or SEZ developers, because if you are supplying to SEZ or SEZ developers, you are not paying taxes, but you are filing your returns and get all that amount which you have paid as taxes back to you. All 100% will be refunded. This is zero rated supply, right? So this supply attracts the GST at 0%. 0% means, see, this is different than again nil rated. Here we are getting all the refunds, but here also we are getting all the refunds, but here you have to pay the taxes. Here you need not pay the taxes. For such supplies, ITC can be claimed. ITC can be claimed at 0%. Please remember this. And non-GST supplies which don't come under the scope of GST are termed as non-GST supplies. Alcohol is the best example because that is out of the GST jurisdiction. It is kept out of the GST by the Constitution. Right? Look at this difference. Look at this table. We have nil rated. We have the types of supplies here and the categories. Nil rated, is GST applicable? Yes, at 0% rate. And what is the type of supply? Everyday items. Everyday items. And do you get ITC input tax credit? Yes. Examples are grain, salt, chakri, rice, wheat, you can write. Exempted supplies. Exempted supply do not apply, do not attract the GST. Type of supply, basic essentials. Eligibility for ITC, no. And the examples are bread, fresh fruits, fresh milk, curd, etc. Zero rated, 0%. Overseas supplies like exports. Exports itself. Supply to SEZ or SEZ developer. Eligibility for ITC, yes. And the examples are this: export, supplies to SEZ unit or SEZ developer. Non-GST do not attract GST. Supplies for which GST is not applicable but can attract other taxes. I repeat, supplies for which GST is not applicable but can attract other taxes. You don't have ITC on it, but look at the example. Alcohol. You are paying taxes on alcohol but not GST. You are paying taxes on petrol but not GST, because they are non-GST items. Hope this table is very clear, and I really hope that you understand the difference between nil rated, exempted and zero rated and non-GST supplies. If you still have doubt, please write in the comment box here just below the video.